Shalom, and welcome to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul, your Biblical Hebrew podcast. Shalom, and welcome to our Biblical Hebrew podcast. Today, I would like to speak to you about one verse from Amos 1:3. We shall read the Hebrew verse and then translate it into English. Kah amar Hashem, so said the Lord, al shlosha pish'e Damascus, about three crimes of Damascus, in brackets, I shall forgive, ve'al arba'a, and on the fourth, lo ashivenu, I shall not forgive. And then comes the description, what is the fourth crime? על דושם בחרוצות הברזל, about their beating with iron pitchforks, את הגלעד, the Gilead. To understand this verse from the inner aspect, we shall have to abstract first the name Damascus in Hebrew. The name Damascus in Hebrew is Damascus. Damascus. The name Damascus is written in four letters. Daled, Mem, Shin, Kof. The volume of the letter Daled is 4. The volume of the letter Mem is 40. The volume of the letter Shin is 300. And the volume of the letter Kof is 100. So, this is the first stage. The second stage is to put aside the zeros from those numbers and look into the little numbers that we see. So Daled remains the 4. Mem, instead of 40, we look at it as 4. And the 400 of the Shin and Kof, we remove the zeros and we're left with 4. So we have 4, 4, 4. So Damascus in little numbers is 4, 4, 4. 3 times 4 is 12. So the little numeral value of Damascus in Hebrew is 12. Now, about three crimes of Damascus, I shall forgive. 3 double 12 is 36. 36 is the number of the righteous man upon the world is standing. In the Hebrew sources, we find many times that the world is standing on the righteousness of 36 men or people. For 36 double 10 spheres, that each one is included of, is 360 full circle. So this is why Amos says, about the three crimes of Damascus, I shall forgive, because the world 360 is still standing. But on the fourth, I cannot forgive. I shall not forgive. And why? Because 4 double 12 is 48. 48 is the value of the word moach in Hebrew, which is mind or brain. But also those are the stem letters of the verb macha, to erase. God uses this verse when he speaks to Noah before the flood. He said that he shall erase the human that he created. Emche. God uses those stem letters. Emche, memchet. So I wish you to see the structure of the prophecy. It's not about the fact that God has feelings, revenge, happiness, sadness. Those feelings are language of humans. Here the Bible speaks about structure. So, about three crimes of Damascus, the world will still stand because it's 36. 36 people still holding everything in completeness. But on the fourth crime, it is not possible to repent, because then comes a structure, 48, that erases everything. It's not a matter of a mood of God. God does not have a mood. Hashem does not have a mood. This is how it is built. And then comes an explanation, what is the fourth crime? Al dusham b'charutzot ha-barzel et ha-gilad. On the fact that they were, of the fact that they were beating with iron forks or pitchforks, the Gilead. What does it mean? When we practice the work of a farmer, the farmer takes this tool, pitchfork, and he beats the sheaf to separate the grains of the wheat from the stem, the separation. So here the prophet Amos uses the same image to explain why on the fourth crime it's impossible to forgive, because the fourth crime is that people try to separate the soul from the body. Four, Gilad is a chain of mountain that lies on the east side of the Jordan. And the east side of the Jordan is the, it's not just physical east, is the side of from which the soul is rising. What was before Adam, Kedem, the spirit of God, and people came, so to speak, with iron tools. And iron in the Bible is the metal that separates everything, separator. The great separator is iron. And they come with iron pitchforks and they're separating the Gilead. They're separating the soul from the body, that the body could never have a salvation. And for this crime, it's impossible to forgive. It's not that God does not want to forgive, but it's impossible to forgive. It doesn't go. It just doesn't go. Because person cannot separate the soul from the body. Once he does it, he cuts his own branch and he falls. So this was our little conversation for today. We wish you a beautiful day and wonderful week.
Thank you for listening to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul. We hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions, comments, or would like to hear more about a certain topic, just write us an email to hebrew@learnoutlife.com. We are always happy to hear from you. For more episodes, videos, and articles like this, please visit our website at hebrew.learnoutlive.com. We also would like to invite you to join our live classes. Just search for Online College of Biblical Hebrew on Facebook and start learning now with students from all over the world. Kol Tuv and Shalom.